Good morning, children. Welcome back to EVS class. Now, last class I had started with chapter 3, that is food for us. I hope you all remember I had started with lesson 3. Lesson 3, what is that lesson? Food. Food for us. I had started food for us. What is that? Now I have finished half of the chapter. Now let us glance, go back, and I'll explain you it in a brief, and then we'll go further. Okay. Food for us means what? What are the food we eat, which is necessary, and how much it is helpful to our health, how much it is good, where we'll build stamina, and then muscle building. All this depends on food, what we eat. So how much food is important for us? So what are the types of food we need for our body? Let us learn that. And already I had taught you. Now what are those foods which are necessary for us? There are two types, and food we get from plants as well as animals also. So two types of foods, that is from plants, we get food from plants, and from animals. So food we get from plants as well as animals. So what for we need food? How much food is useful and helpful to us? Our body needs energy, that means stamina, strength. So for that, what we need is food. So food gives us strong energy. It makes us strong, healthy, everything. Okay. So by eating all these varieties of food, we get nice strength. We'll grow nicely. Okay. So there are so many helpful things. So in that food, we have got two types of food, from plants and from animals. Okay. Plants, we generally everybody eat. So what are those food? Food from plants we get is fruits and vegetables. So we get fruits and vegetables. Fruits, vegetables. And from animals are, what we get from animals are flesh. Okay, some of them, those who eat non-veg, especially I'll make it non-veg. Non-veg, okay. Fish, meat. So all these are, what you tell it, we get from animals. And then hens, goat, okay, and it is flesh of animals, okay, flesh of animals, that is fish, hens, goat, etc., like this. And above that, we get milk products also. From animals, that is, we get milk from cow. We prepare butter, curd, ghee, everything from milk products. And moreover, along with fruits and vegetables, we get cereals and pulses also from plants. We get pulses, cereals, okay, from plants. So many varieties of food we get. In that, there are again two different kinds: energy giving food, body building food, and protective food. We have got three types of food. We have got three types: energy giving, body building protective food. So in food also we have got three types, again depending on our body health, everything. So what are those? Energy giving foods, body building foods, and protective foods. Okay, now what are the energy giving foods, body building foods, and protective foods? So each of this division has got different foods separate. So if you eat this kind of food, you will get energy, and such a kind of food, we get body building, muscle building. Okay, and protective food, which protects us. So yes, last class I had finished energy giving foods. What are energy giving foods? Foods that give us energy to work. Food that gives us energy to work and play are called energy giving foods. When we eat some foods, we get nice energy. We get stamina to work, to play, to do all other activities. So it is called energy giving foods. You should include some of these foods in your meal every day. Which are those foods? Rice, chapati, palya, potato, cucumber, bread, sugar, and honey, butter. So these are energy giving foods. All these varieties of foods give you energy. So last class I had finished till here. Now let us continue with next, that is body building foods. Body building foods. Open page number 173. Page 173. I will read and I will explain along with that. Okay. Body building foods. Foods that build our bones and muscles. Food that builds our bones and muscles. Muscles are what you have got here. The muscles and bones. Bones inside the body where you can't see. Okay. That is the inner part. So bones and muscles are inside our body, which gives strength and stamina and the stiffness, body supporting. So that has to be built nicely. It needs nice stamina. So the food which you eat, it should give nice strength for muscles also, bones also. So such kind of food is called bodybuilding food, which builds your muscles, which makes your bone strong. These foods help us to grow. So when you eat these kind of foods, it helps us to grow height, grow tall, okay, and make your body fit. You should include some of these foods in your meal every day. So which are those food? I'll tell you. For bodybuilding food. Okay, now I'll erase this. What are those foods which helps your body to build, make strong, which helps you to grow everything? So bodybuilding foods. Bodybuilding food. Which are those which gives nice stamina, nice muscles, nice body, okay, and which helps you to grow? Which are those? Pulses and cereals, milk, egg, meat, okay? You can see. Pulses, cereals, milk, egg, fish, and you can see this non-veg, that is chicken, I think so, okay, etc. You can see in the picture, children, here, okay? So all these foods makes your body grow. It will build your body, it will build your muscles, bones will become strong, you will grow nicely, your body will be healthy and fit, strong. Okay, so that is the reason it is called body building food, where it builds up your body. Okay, understood, children. Now turn to next page. After body building food, next comes, which is next, protective food. Next is protective food. What are protective food? Protective food means what? I'll read out. Foods which protect us from diseases and keep us healthy are called protective foods. Food what we eat, okay, which protects us from diseases and keeps us healthy, which will protect us from any diseases, fever, cough, cold, all these things, and which makes us be healthy. So such kind of food is called protective food, which protects our body from against the diseases. These foods prevent us from falling sick and keep us healthy. I told you these foods, that means which are those foods, I'll make a list. So these foods, when you eat, it keeps your body healthy, it fights against the diseases, germs, everything which makes us fall sick. So these foods, when you intake, so it will protect you from falling sick and makes you healthy. You should include some of these foods in your meal every day. So every day, see that you eat these foods so that your body will be protected against all these diseases and sickness. Which are those foods? Fruits and vegetables. All types of, there is no particular one type. All types of fruits, all types of fruits and vegetables. Okay, children, all types of fruits you should eat, vegetables you should eat, so that your body will be protected from sickness, illness. It will protect nicely, you will not fall sick, you will be healthy. So such kind of foods are called protective foods. Next, people like different types of food. So people, they like different types of food. Even you also, yes or no, when your mummy prepares every day rice sambar asamal, do you like? No. 1 or 2 days you will eat, and next day you will tell, what is this mummy, same thing you are preparing, isn't it? So same way, All the people, they like different types of food. They eat fruits, vegetables, milk, cheese and grains. So they all eat fruits also, vegetables also, milk, cheese, everything they will eat. They do not eat fish and meat. Such people are called vegetarians. And remember one thing, people who eat all types of fruits and vegetables. Okay, they eat fruits, vegetables, milk products, everything. Only these things. And they do not eat fish and meat are called vegetarians. Okay, those who don't eat non-veg, that is chicken, mutton, fish, whatever you all eat, no? Some of them. So fish and meat, those who don't eat, they're called vegetarians. These vegetarians, they eat only fruits and vegetables and spinaches. So what you call, only these things, milk, curd, butter, all these things they eat, that's all. And they are called vegetarians. Some people like to eat meat, fish, egg. Okay, they are called non-vegetarians. Some people, they eat fish also, chicken, mutton, eggs, all these, and such kind of people are called non-vegetarians. Non-vegetarians, they eat even fruits, vegetables, milk products, everything. Along with that, their food will be even fish, meat, chicken, all the eggs, all these things, and these people are called non-vegetarians. Okay, non-vegetarians means eat fish, meat, eggs. Vegetarians only fruits and vegetables. Okay, vegetarians, they eat only fruits and vegetables, they are called vegetarians. Non-vegetarians, they eat fish, meat, eggs, along with that vegetables also they eat, and they are called non-veg people. Now, a proper balanced diet, regular exercise, proper rest and cleanliness together keep us happy and healthy. So what are the things? Now, eating nicely, sleeping or eating nicely, and just sitting and watching TV or not maintaining neatness, all these things, it's not a proper diet. So what is proper diet? A balanced diet means regular exercise should be there, proper rest also you have to take, and cleanliness, take bath every day, often wash your hands, all these things, and all by doing all this, take proper rest, play in proper time, everything, doing all these things keeps you healthy and fit, okay, and you will be happy also. So food, good food habits, what are those good food habits? We should start the day with a healthy breakfast. So morning when you get up, what you do? First you will get up everything, you drink milk or something, and then what you should do? You should start your day with a healthy breakfast. It should be healthy, strong. And eat your meals at a fixed time. Always you should have meals in a proper time. One day eating, no. Your meal should be always in one particular fixed time. Wash your hands before and after every meal. Before eating food and after eating food, you should wash your hands. Chew your food properly means you have to bite nicely. You should not just gulp it inside and leave it off, because it may cause indigestion. Your food may not get digested in your stomach. Then stomach upset will happen, you get stomachache, all these things. So when food has to be digested, what you have to do? You have to chew the food. You have got nice teeth, no? So you have to chew your food nicely. Eat fresh food. Always eat fresh food. Don't keep the food remaining in fridge. Eat tomorrow, day after tomorrow, like that. No. Anything for that matter, it's not rice, sambar or whatever. Any even snacks items also, don't store it in the fridge for more than one day. Today for tomorrow, okay. So, but it is better always that day's food, that day you should finish it off when it is fresh. Okay. And do not eat junk food. You should not eat junk food more. To some extent, little bit, once in a while, okay. But not every day, often, no need to eat junk food at all. It is very harmful for your health. Then eat healthy food and stay healthy. Eat a healthy food. Healthy food means what is that? So till now I have taught all this. Healthy food means fruits, vegetables, grains, pulses, all this. For non-veg people, they eat non-veg also. And even spinach, all this thing you have, it is a healthy food. Eat healthy food, then you will be healthy. Now, going to next page. I know they have given in the box what all you know, we get food from plants and animals. A balanced diet is the proper quantity of food in each group. The three different kinds of foods are energy giving foods, protective foods and bodybuilding foods. Foods which protect us from diseases are called protective foods. People who do not eat fish, eggs and meat are called vegetarians. We should eat our meals at a fixed time. We should wash our hands before and after Each meal, that means not once you wash finished, no. Every time when you are eating, not only meal, anything when you eat, before eating, see that always you wash your hand first and then eat. Because when you will be touching here, there or something, your hand will be containing germs where you can't see directly. So it's better always you wash your hands first and then you can start eating. Okay, children, by this, I have ended the chapter. Lesson, which lesson? Food for us, lesson number 3. So here it ends and I'll do the exercises. Here exercises are only 2. You want to copy down this? I'll give 1 minute time. You can copy down. Later we'll do fill in the blanks. I want you to open your textbook. Okay. And third main, give 2 examples of each of the following. In between second main, you have got tick the foods we get from plants. The plants, what all food we get, you have to put tick mark, okay? And one more thing, I have got the chart also, children. Types of food, food for us, our foods, if you go, you will get the chart. I'll send it in the classwork, okay? So next, you have to paste the pictures. What are the like energy giving food, bodybuilding food, everything. Take the chart, cut, paste it. At the end of the chapter, I'll be sending like previous chapter, how I made, same thing. So this is the chart. I hope you all can see. Okay. So like this chart you take, you have got here cereals, rice, vegetables, fruits, milk, non-vegetarians. So in this, you should study, read from your textbook which are energy giving food, which are bodybuilding food, and which are the protective foods. Make 3 columns, space these pictures there and label them. Okay. So I have got this one model chart so that it will be easy for you. Cut. First you write one main. I'll show you how to write. I'll be giving in the classwork, you will come to know, but still I'll show you how to. First you write, put one. First one is energy giving food. Energy giving food. Write heading. Below that, paste the pictures. How many are there? So many in one sheet. Okay, in one sheet you can paste the pictures. Below that, write the name of that food, all energy giving food. Next page, 2. Next comes bodybuilding food. Bodybuilding food. Again, paste the pictures, name them. It is not only 2. How many pictures will be having? So many you can paste. After that, number 3, go to next page and write protective foods. Okay, protective foods. Same thing, paste the pictures, write the name below that. What food, what is the name of that? Okay. So that is why I have got this for you to show. You will get the chart like this, paste it in your classwork book. Okay. Now I'll rub this. We'll start up with exercises. Okay, I'll be erasing this. I hope you all have copied. I'll write down the assignment also. This is your assignment. Learn and write. Question answer from lesson one, I think. Lesson one. One time. Fourth question. What is the main function of the heart? The main heart answer. Fifth one, how does the brain help us? Sixth one, how should we take care of our body? Okay, this is your assignment, children. Copy down. Okay. Now let us start with exercises. Okay, for today's fill in the blanks. Exercises. I'll be writing down only the answers. Okay. Fill in the blanks. First one, we get, I want you all to open the textbook, okay, so that you can write down the answer. We get food from dash and dash. From where we get food? We get food from plants and animals. Plants and animals. Okay. Second one. We get dash and dash from animals. What we get from animals? we get dash and dash from animals. We get meat, and that is non-veg things. We get even milk products also. We get milk and flesh from animals. Okay, children, we get from animals, what all we get? We get milk products also, and we get flesh also from animals. Here somewhere it is. We get milk and flesh. We get milk and flesh from animals. Okay. Third one, dash and dash are energy giving foods. You should give examples which are energy giving foods. Rice and sugar. Rice and sugar. And you can write any other also. They are given in the picture, which are examples for energy giving foods. You can write chapati also, bread. So many things are there in picture they have given. You can write any two. Grains and pulses are dash foods. Grains and pulses are bodybuilding foods. Body fifth one, people who eat fish, egg and meat are called, those who eat all this flesh of animals and everything, they are called non-vegetarians. Okay, next, sixth one, we should eat our dash at fixed time. We should eat our meal. M-E-A-L-S, meals. Seventh one, we should not eat dash food, not eat junk food. Okay, now copy down this. After this, second main you have got, pick the foods we get from plants. You have to put tick mark like this on the picture. That is easy for you. I'm telling, see, fruits and vegetables you get from plants. Potato you get from plants. And then corn you get from plants, but not egg. Egg is, hen gives us egg, you know. And then even milk also we get from cow. And next is that meat or whatever it is, that is meat. So that also we get from animals. So only these three are foods which we get from plants. Put tick mark for that. Next, third main, give two examples of each of the following that I'll write down here. Okay. Third main. Third main. First one. Energy giving foods, bread, chapati. Upati. Second one. Bodybuilding foods, milk, egg. Egg. Third one, protective foods, fruits and vegetables. Okay, children, by this I have completed the exercises also. Next, think about it. Put these foods in the right column. Here they have given the pictures and they have given the columns also. Energy giving foods, bodybuilding foods and protective foods. All these pictures you have to write the names and put it in the right column. This is for you to do at home. You have to think after reading the lesson. You have to think and you have to write on your own. This you make it as homework and for your practice they have given. Okay. By this, I will end up the class. I have finished this third chapter. In next class, we will start up with next chapter, fourth chapter, clothes we wear. Okay. Now, I will give you 1 minute time. Copy down the assignment also and this exercises also. Okay. Okay, children, I hope you all have copied. See, if you have not copied properly, you can pause the video. You can see I have left at the end. I for everything what I write on the board, I am giving 1 minute time for you to copy and I am coming to site. That time you can pause the video and then note down the answers, whatever I have written on the board. Okay, this is your assignment. I want you all to write it neatly. You will be knowing which are the books, everything. Okay, children, read the lesson, practice nicely. Okay, till then, thank you.